Welcome. My name is Michael Zauner and I'm a PhD student at the Christian Doppler Laboratory for Innovative Control and Monitoring of Automotive Powertrain Systems. Today's topic is going to be about an advanced flatness-based control concept for battery emulation. It's no secret that the market share of electric vehicles is growing rapidly, and the next generation of electric vehicles will have a faster charging capability, have greater range, and be overall more performant. And in order to achieve those goals, new electric components are being developed right now. And to test those electric components, high performance test systems are needed. With high performance, we don't just mean cutting edge hardware. We also mean advanced control concepts for enhanced testing capabilities. But first, before we dive right in, let me give you a brief overview on the Christian Doppler Laboratory. The Christian Doppler Laboratory is a multiple year long cooperation between TU Wien and EWLIST GmbH in Graz under our laboratory head, Dr. Christoph Hamedner. Their primary research focuses are component models for state estimation, diagnosis and degradation mitigation, power hill testing under real driving conditions, and predictive multi-level control and operating strategies. Let's return now to the topic by looking at an application example, the development of electric components for a hybrid electric vehicle, for example. We can group the components needed for such a vehicle into three parts. First, the internal combustion engine. Secondly, the onboard battery. And a group connecting those two components together would be a combination of electric motor and inverter. If we now utilize a classical testing setup, as shown here on the slide, we would need a working prototype of each of the components groups in order to perform tests. This introduces an unwanted dependency between different components groups and a development delay of just one component would lead to delays in the whole project. In order to solve this problem, one can utilize hardware-in-the-loop test systems. Hereby, some physical components of the testbed are being replaced with highly dynamic actuators and according mathematical models which describe the behavior of the replaced components. In the example of our electric motor and inverter combination, we could replace the internal combustion engine with a dynamometer and the battery with a battery emulator. Especially replacing a battery on a testbed is highly beneficial, as using a real battery has many disadvantages attached to it. First, a real battery needs to be preconditioned before each test run, which is time and energy consuming. Secondly, it's also dangerous. Short circuits from faulty units under test could easily lead to fires. And finally, such a physical battery has only a limited lifetime. It's much more efficient and beneficial to use instead a hardware-in-the-loop test setup with a battery emulator instead. And since today's focus is a control concept for battery emulators, let us look at the main challenge which arises from using battery emulators. A highly dynamic voltage control is required for battery emulators. Recall that we also have a mathematical model with the replaced component behavior behind our battery emulator, and this mathematical model now supplies a reference trajectory for a voltage that we try to track as fast and as accurately as possible in order to achieve the best possible testing results. And We also have to keep in mind that with such high dynamic on the output wanted, that our computing resources are limited. Our team was tasked to develop a high performance controller, which should be real-time capable, should have extremely high dynamics on the output, have a large operating range, and have a keen focus on low voltage stability. In order to achieve this, we modeled the system as follows. Since we don't actually know what units will be connected to our battery emulator, it can be anything and is not just limited to an electric motor and inverter combination as shown beforehand, we choose to model the unit under test as a constant power load. This is also the worst case scenario, as with a constant power load, the whole system becomes not just nonlinear, but also unstable. We can collect the differential equations describing our battery emulator and the constant power load into a nonlinear system called sigma nonlinear. We can then linearize the system around an operating point and call this now linearized system sigma L. On the right, we can see the nonlinear characteristics of such a constant power load in blue. The linearized system, shown in black, is approximating this nonlinear characteristic in the operating point quite well. But if we move away from the operating point, modeling errors arise and grow rapidly. Since we also want a wide, viable operating range, this leads to problems. Therefore, we developed a highly dynamic flatness-based control concept, which was possible as both the nonlinear system and the linear system were flat and have full relative degree on the output. This means we can write down the output and its time derivatives and express them as functions of the state variable x and the input u. Please note, since we have full relative degree, that only the last equation for each model, which is the fourth time derivative of the output, is dependent on the input. The other equations are not actually dependent on the input, but only depend on the state variable x. We can collect those equations now into transformations. Please keep in mind that both transformations, so the one for the nonlinear system and the one for the linear system, are diffeomorphisms, which means that the function itself is smooth, an inverse exists, and this inverse is also smooth. We can now describe our control concept in detail. From the plant, we collect measurements and compose the state vector x of our nonlinear system. By collecting now the nonlinear system and the linear system, such that both have the same output up to the third time derivative, we are able to compute the linear system states xL. Please note that these linear system states are just virtual system states. They don't generally coincide with the measured system state. Since we now have a linear model, we are able to design a linear controller which computes the stabilizing control input UL reference. This control input is also just a virtual input and cannot be applied to the plant directly. But by also connecting the linear system and the nonlinear system such that they both have the same output up to the fourth time derivative, we are able to compute the required input, which can be applied to the plant and thus closing the control loop. Next, let us look at some simulation results. Here we can see a comparison between our flatness-based control concept and a naive, poorly linear control. The blue solid line on the graph on the right is the output voltage of the battery emulator with the flatness-based control concept, and the dotted line is the output of a poorly linear controller. Both controllers use the same linearization point at 150 volts and start also there at time step 0. We can see that when we are tasked to follow the reference W, which is the green line, that our control concept is able to do this, and it's not only able to do this in the vicinity of the operating point, but also further and further down. On the other hand, this poorly linear controller starts to become an offset, and the tracking performance gets worse and worse until at some point the voltage collapses to zero. Both controllers are of course tuned equivalently to enable a fair comparison. This in conclusion tells us that our flatness-based control concept is able to stabilize the system further away from its linearization point than a poorly linear implementation. We also collected real-time test results on experimental hardware. For this, we used a control hill environment to collect the test results. The controller was running on a real prototype hardware board from our industrial partner, and this prototype hardware board is going to be implemented in the next generation of battery emulator systems. The rest of the system was simulated via a real-time simulator, which was in our case a Hill system or from Typhon. On the far right, you can see the results of such a real-time test. The upper plot shows the voltage of our system, and we start with a reference of about 400 volt, and shortly after we perform a step up to 500 volts. We are able to follow this step in less than 1 millisecond, showcasing the highly dynamic output that we wanted. Then we require a step to go down to 100 volts, which we are able to do without a problem, showcasing the wide viable operating range of our control concept. As an outlook for future content, let's look at other research focuses that are being worked on right now. This higher power application that we are going to present here is a result of the advancing electrification of heavy-duty powertrains. Since these heavy-duty powertrains need a lot of current, and this current draw can be higher than the current draw of a single battery emulator, we need a test system which is able to deliver high load currents, and it's an efficient solution for this problem to just parallel multiple battery emulators together. But when we do so, it's much more challenging to provide a stable DC bus voltage. Therefore, an ongoing task of our work group is to develop a decentralized controller. This decentralized controller is built on top of an already existing control concept of our industrial partner and augments it so that an optimal cooperation between the individual units is achieved. And we can achieve this by very little communication overhead, which is beneficial as this enables a retrofitting possibility for existing battery emulators. If you are interested in any of the topics presented today or feel like you could benefit from the cooperation with us, please feel free to contact us, and we are looking forward from hearing from you. Thank you for your attention.